Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the West Hartford Townwide Spelling Bee. My name is Jennifer Mitos. I'm the Executive Director of the Noah Webster House in West Hartford Historical Society. And this is our second year collaborating with West Hartford Public Schools, and it's our pleasure to be able to offer a Townwide Bee to the students of West Hartford, which of course is the hometown of everyone's favorite speller, Noah Webster. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary, which is the direct descendant of Webster's original dictionary, is the ultimate authority that is used for the Scripps National Spelling Bee. This is a Scripps Spelling Bee, so the winners, the top speller from each school here tonight, will move on to the next round, which I'm happy to announce if you look over the back of your program. The Noah Webster House is sponsoring a Connecticut statewide spelling bee, the Connecticut Spelling Bee. And this is the first time in a long time that there will be an official state bee. We actually found out from Scripps National Bee that this year nobody was going to take on a regional bee. And we didn't step up. Connecticut would be the only state in the United States not to have a statewide bee, which we thought would be pretty sad considering it's Noah Webster's home state. So we're very pleased to be able to offer this opportunity to students from all over the state. And you can be assured that three of the spellers here tonight are going to move on to the next round. The winner from the Connecticut statewide bee will then move on to Scripps National Bee. So that winner will be representing Connecticut on the national stage. For those of you who have never been, the Noah Webster House is right on South Main Street. We're a nonprofit museum and cultural destination where citizens can learn to understand and appreciate the past. We preserve, of course, the birthplace of Noah Webster, the founding father, educator, author, and lexicographer who taught generations of Americans what it means to be American. We also serve as the repository for the history of West Hartford, the community that molded Noah Webster's future and is still thriving over 250 years later. When wondering what Mr. Paleologopoulos and I were doing up on the stage there, we were giving some last-minute instructions to the spellers. I hope everyone had an opportunity to take a look at the rules for the West Hartford Spelling Bee, and that's basically what we went through with the students to make sure that everyone was on the same page about what their options are. So we reminded the spellers that they can ask the pronouncer to say the word again, define it, use it in a sentence, provide the part of speech, provide the language of origin, and provide an alternate pronunciation. There's not much you can do to get disqualified from the bee. One is if you refuse to start spelling. So if you come out of a freeze, obviously that would be a disqualification. And anyone who engages in unsportsmanlike conduct, which seems highly unlikely today, so I think we're going to be in great shape. I'd like to thank Tom Paleologopoulos, who's the supervisor of English at West Hartford Public Schools, who has been running this bee for many, many years and is training the Noah Webster House on how to conduct it. And I'd also like to introduce Amy Goldstein, who is our pronouncer. She's actually, this is her second year as our pronouncer. She lives in West Hartford. She works at ESPN, and she is a speller herself. She's gone through the spelling circuit, she's been to Scripps National Bee, and she served as a pronouncer at the Long Island Spelling Bee for many, many years. So it's my pleasure to introduce Amy Goldstein.
She plays on a basketball team, and she loves skiing with her family on weekends. Noah Kaufman Asden is a sixth grader at Sedgwick Middle School. When he isn't reading or writing short stories and novels, he can be
basketball, and soccer. so well. The biographies for the students were written by their teachers that sent them here tonight. Speaking of which, I see several in the audience. So if you want to, like, a West Harbor Public School middle school teacher who's here with their students, right, could you stand up, please?
Belief is spelled B-E-L-I-E-F. Janitor. Observe. O-B-S-E-R-V-E. Observe.
That is correct.
Anteater.
That is correct.
hand or machine needles. Knitting.
K-N-I-T-T-I-N-G. Knitting.
That is correct.
Deadline. Complaints is spelled C-O-M-P-L-A-I-N-T-S. Nonsense.
Nonsense. N-O-N-S-E-N-S-E. Nonsense.
Yes, that is correct.
Laundry.
Laundry.
Lodging means a temporary place to stay.
Lodging? Lodging. L-O-D-G-I-N-G. Lodging?
That is correct.
Your word has a homonym. Veins. Carry blood from different parts of your body to your heart. Veins.
Veins. V-E-I-N-S.
That is correct.
Mountain.
Mountain. M O U N. T-A-I-N, mountain.
That is correct.
Mountain.
Performance.
Performance. Performance.
That is correct.
Biology.
Biology. Biology.
That is correct.
This word has a homonym, clause. It means a group of words in a sentence that has its own subject and verb. Clause.
Is correct.
Specific.
Specific.
That is correct. It's a spelling bee, it's not a pronunciation. That is correct.
Invisible.
Invisible. I-N-V-I-S-I-E-L-E.
That is correct. That is correct.
Failure.
That is correct.
Your word has a near homonym, beckon. It means to appear inviting or attract. Beckon.
Beckon.
No, I'm sorry, that is not correct.
Beckon is spelled B-E-C-K-O-N. Fortune.
Fortune. F-O-R-T-U-N-E. Fortune.
That is correct.
Dimension. Dimension is spelled D-I-M-E-N-S-I-O-N. Caterpillar.
Caterpillar. C-A-T-E-R-P-I-L-L-A-R. Caterpillar.
That is correct.
T-I-G-H-T-R-O-P-E.
is correct.
Applause. This is a noun. It means approval publicly expressed as by clapping hands. Applause.
Applause. A P P L A U S E. Applause.
That is correct.
Innocent.
That is correct.
Digestive.
That is correct. Sorry, that is not correct.
Settee is spelled S-E-T-T-E-E. Cupboard.
Cupboard? Mm-hmm. Cupboard. C-U-P-B-O-A-R-D. Cupboard.
That is correct. One of the difficulties with spelling bees is that when you think you've heard the word, you start spelling it. And sometimes the word you think you've heard is not the word that the pronouncer said. Some words that we've had here tonight, you obviously saw that student knows how to spell the word, but they've spelled a variant of that word. They've used a past tense. They used a plural S. Or simply not heard the word clearly enough that they are pronouncing a word they think they've been asked to spell correctly. I appreciate that. But when a speller needs clarity, they are to ask the question, say the word. And when I hear the word said correctly and spelling start, we have to judge on that word. I've asked to speak with Ms. Nicola Matos. I think there are three students that might be added to this second round based on this qualification. I'm going to speak briefly with her. This is the Noah Webster House Spelling Bee in conjunction with the West Hartford Public Schools. We're going to try and make a fair decision based on what we've heard. Be with you in a moment.
You will forgive me. I don't know your children's names as well as I should. Actually, Mr. Polamich will not call three spellers back to the stage. With this understanding, spellers, if you are not sure that you've heard the word correctly, you can ask the word to be repeated.
And use it in a sentence. Ask for it to be used in a sentence. Then you will understand exactly how the word is to be used. Don't forget, you have that option.
You have part of speech. You have so many options at your disposal. Just ask for them. There's some funny sentences in here. You might get them.
So the three words that we believe were not misspelled. They were misspelled based on
the wrong word was spelled correctly.
Wrong word was spelled correctly. Tyler Denault, Aliyah Brown, and Sophie Gardner McKinnon. So we're going to reinstate you for round three.
Almost forgot.
Because teaspoon was a round one word,
you have a round two word to spell. So if you head up to the microphone, we'll get rid of your round two word. And then yes, yes.
Okay. Just because she was out in round one, this was round two, she still has to spell a word in round two. And then round two will thankfully be over.
Round two word is marooned. Listen carefully, marooned. It means put ashore on a desolate island or coast and left to one's fate.
Marooned.
That is correct. You did spell the word around too. You spell the word one and two, so.
But 17 needs to spell the word around two. She didn't spell it.
That's Sophie.
Sophie, did you?
She got out first round.
Okay, Sophie, sorry, this is your round two word.
Daunted. D-A-U-N-T-E-D. Daunted.
That is correct.
Moisture.
Moisture. M-O-I-S-T-U-R-E. Moisture.
That is correct.
He does bring attention.
Gymnastics.
Gymnastics. G Y M N A S T I C S. Gymnastics.
That is correct.
Inlet.
Reaching depths of 1,933 meters below sea level, one of the deepest fjords in the world is Skelton Inlet in Antarctica, which is filled with ice from a glacier. Inlet.
Clodhopper is a large, heavy shoe.
Clodhopper. C-L-O-V-H-O-T-P-E-R, Clodover.
That's correct.
Quash, it means put an end to.
Quash, Q-U-A-S-H-E-D.
That is correct.
Dandruff.
Dandruff. D-A-N-D-R-U-F-F. Dandruff.
That is correct.
Cutlery.
Cutlery. C-U-T-L-E-R-Y. Cutlery.
That is correct.
Gnarled.
Gnarled. Are the definitions?
Warped or twisted, with or as if with knots.
Okay. Gnarled, G-N-A-R-L-E-D, gnarled.
That is correct.
Yes, go ahead.
Your word as a near homonym, equestrian, of, relating to, or featuring horseback riding. It's an adjective.
Equestrian. E-Q-U-E-S-T-R-I-A-N. Equestrian?
That is correct.
Bedraggled.
Bedraggled. B E D R A G G L E D. Bedraggled.
That is correct.
Paisley.
Paisley. P-A-I-S-L-E-Y, Paisley.
That is correct.
That concludes round three.
Any other misspelled words in this round should please leave the stage. Sorry, that's not correct.
Cavalcade is spelled C-A-V-A-L-C-A-V-E.
Okay.
tenaciously.
That is correct.
Icarus. 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 Can you say that one?
Icarus is a figure in Greek mythology who flies away from imprisonment using artificial wings, but falls when he flies too close to the sun, melting the wax of his wings. Icarus. You don't have to.
You don't have to.
I-C-A-R-U-S, Icarus.
That is correct.
Scrumptiously.
Scrumptiously. S-C-R-U-M-P-T-I-O-U-S-L-Y. Scrumptiously.
That is correct.
Burglarious.
Burglarious means of or suitable for the use of one who breaks into a building illegally, especially with the intent to steal.
Burglarious.
Burglarious. B U R G L A R I O U S burglarious.
That is correct.
Thaumaturge. Thaumaturge is a person who performs miracles, a magician. Thaumaturge.
That is correct.
Vulpine. Vulpine.
Vulpine means marked by slyness or predatoriness, crafty.
No, I'm sorry, that is not.
Vulpine is spelled V-U-L-P-I-N-E. Honolulu.
Honolulu.
That is correct.
Neutron.
Neutron. N-E-U-T-R-O-N. Neutron.
That is correct.
Catastrophic.
Catastrophic. C-A-T-A-S-T-R-O-T-H-I-T.
That is correct. Yes, you can.
Mahogany.
Mahogany is spelled M-A-H-O-G-A-N-Y.
correct.
Perpetrator.
Could you give me a definition?
A perpetrator is one that commits an offense or crime.
Perpetrator. P-E-T-R-A-T-O-R. Perpetrator.
That is correct.
Insulin. I-N-S-U-L-I-N. Insulin.
That is correct.
Mylar.
Can you say it again?
Mylar.
Mylar? M-I-L-A-R-E?
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
M-I-L-A-R.
Bless you.
Physicists.
Physicists.
P. H-Y-S-I-C-I-S-T-S.
That is correct.
Stilton.
Stilton. Can I have a definition?
Stilton is a blue vein cheese with wrinkled rind made of whole cow's milk and ripped with cream and usually aged 2 years. Stilton.
Stilton. S-T-I-L-T-O-N. Stilton.
That is correct.
Five-minute break, yeah.
We're going to take a five-minute break for, obviously, if you want to get up, get it right.
Oh!
Is it really?
habanero.
It's also habanero and habanero. Legitimately is spelled L-E-G-I-T-I-M-A-T-E-L-Y. Pilgrimages.
Can you say it one again?
Pilgrimages.
Pilgrimages.
Spelled I-N-C-O-N-C-E-I-V-A-V-L-A.
innervating.
Can you use that as a sentence?
Zara found that working in the hot sun all day was enervating her.
Kind of definition.
Enervating means lessening the nerve vitality or strength of.
Enervating. E-N-N-E-R-V-A-T-I-N-G. Enervating.
I'm sorry, that is not correct.
Okay. Enervating is spelled E-N-E-R-V-A-T-I-N-G. Jacobean, it means of or relating to James the First of England, his reign or his times. Jacobean.
Jacobean. J A C K A B I A N. Jacobean.
I'm sorry, that is not correct.
Jacobean is spelled J A C O B E A N.
Just to let you know that there are still multiple spellers from each school, so it hasn't been determined. You know, when we recognize that the last speller from a school has gone out, Ms. Nicola Matos will let you know that that speller will still go on to the regional.
Round 6. Silhouetted.
S I L H O U E T T E D.
That is correct.
Represent.
Can you repeat that, please?
Represent.
Can I get an issue?
Represent means refusing to submit to authority.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
It's also recusant.
Recusant, R-E-C-U-S-E-N-T, recusant?
I'm sorry, that's not correct.
Recusant is spelled R-E-C-U-S-A-N-T. Potentialities. Simone's science class discussed the potentialities inherent in modern technology.
Can you repeat the word?
Potentialities.
P-O-T-E-N-T-I-A-L.
It is correct.
Gesticulations.
Gesticulations. G E F T I C U L A T I O N S. Gesticulations.
That is correct.
Patagonia. P-A-T-A-G-O-N-I-A. Patagonia.
That is correct.
Interminableness.
Interminableness. I N T E R N I N A B L E N E S S. Interminableness.
That is correct.
Prestidigitation.
Prestidigitation. P R E S T I D I G I T A T I O N. Prestidigitation.
That is correct.
That concludes round six. Round seven. This word has a near homonym, constabulary. Constabulary means a body of police officers, as in a particular town, district, or country. Constabulary.
Constabulary. C O N S T A B U L A R Y. Constabulary.
Pugnacious. The safari leader told the group about his encounter with a pugnacious bush pig. I don't know what a bush pig is. I'm curious now. Pugnacious. Can I hear you say it, please?
Pugnacious.
Can you say it a little closer to mine?
Pugnacious.
I'm sorry.
P-U-G-N-A-T-I-O-U-S.
I'm sorry, that is not correct. Pugnacious is spelled P-U-G-N-A-C-I-O-U-S. Eucalyptus.
Eucalyptus.
Amrit will be
2008. Castellated.
Castellated. C-A-S-T-E-L-L-A-T-E-D. Castellated.
That is correct.
Hebrides.
Hebrides. H-E-B-R-I-D-E-S. Hebrides.
That is correct.
Nautilus.
Nautilus. N-A-U-T-I-L-U-S. Nautilus.
That is correct.
This word has a homonym. Your word is phosphine. This phosphine is a colorless, very poisonous, gaseous compound that may ignite spontaneously when mixed with air or oxygen, and that is a weaker base than ammonia. Phosphine.
Phosphine. P-H-O-S-P-H-I-N-E. Phosphine.
That is correct.
Here are the end of the procedures. While it doesn't seem like they're ever going to spell a word wrong, eventually one or two of them will. To win the spelling bee, you have to spell two words correctly. So if two of these spellers misspell a word and the person who's left spells the word correctly, they still have to spell the anticipated championship word. If they misspell the anticipated championship word, all spellers come back in. Okay? So if it seems a bit strange, it's the only difference in regular elimination. There has to be one clear winner. If that person does not spell the anticipated championship word, all spellers that began that round return.
No, you're only spelling what? If all the other spellers misspell their words, then you would get it.
One at a time, so.
We're going to start with word 301. Your word has a homonym, adherence. It's a singular noun and means the act, action, or quality of holding, following, or maintaining loyalty steadily and consistently. Adherence.
Adherence. A-D-H-E-R-D-N-C-E. Adherence.
That is correct.
Contemptible.
Contemptible. Contemptible.
I'm sorry, that is not correct.
Contemptible spelled contemptible. Municipality.
Municipality. Municipality. M-U-N-I-C-I-P-A-L-I.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Municipality.
M-U-N-I-C-I-P-A-L-I-T-Y, municipality.
That is correct.
Flammable.
That is correct.
decisively. INDECISIVELY, indecisively.
That is correct.
Round 13, word 340. This word has a homonym. Your word is new. This new is a large African antelope with a head like an ox, a short mane, a long tail, and horns that curve downward and outward and then up. New.
Can you repeat the word, please?
It's new or new?
New. N-Y-V.
I'm sorry, that is not correct.
New spelled G-N-U. Amendment.
Amendment. A-M-E-N-D. Amendment.
That is correct.
And thankfully, the only speller to spell his word correctly during this round. If he spells his next word correctly, he will be champion. Round 14. Detestable.
Detestable. D-E-T-E-S-T. A-B-L-E, detestable.
That is correct.
Wow, I don't know.